Trev's Corner. I'm your host, Trevor Greg, joined by Tom Lipson from the North Haven Footy Club.
Hi, mate. How are you going?
Very good, thank you, sir. Now, looking at Division 3 reserves, and it was really just a case of, even over the past few weeks, it's just been a battle of the top five. Everybody else down from 6th to 10th has been, or 9th, sorry, is not really been in it at all, and the bye hasn't really played into it too much, but Flinders Park obviously having the bye for the last round of the year, that it sucked.
That would really suck.
So looking into the finals, but we'll have a look at the first game that happened on the weekend, and before we review what's going on in the first week of finals. And Foscannon hosted Plympton, and it was a tough day out for the Bulldogs. No goals scored until the third quarter, and that was it. So it was 24-15, 159, and Plympton, one goals, and six total.
Confidence booster going into the finals.
And a big end to Plympton's year. Williams with six, Papatolis with five, the brothers, M. Papatolis with the three, McDonald three, Sopper with a couple, and pretty much everybody else on the team sheet got one. Tui, Papatolis, McDonald, Williams and Walters were the best players for Fossies.
Plympton's goal kickers were A. Hartman.
Good boy.
And that is it. Best players are Warren Barnes, Farrell, Cassidy and Pitt.
Yeah, it's been really tough for Plympton. They have had the four wins, but their B brace was I think they were fairly strong last year, but not the case this year. Next game, another belting at Haslam Oval. 17-14, 166, Old Ignatians beating Pembroke 2-1-13.
Really good win. Pembroke struggling as well though, so no surprise.
Not Damo's favourite club.
Pembroke.
Mm.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't like Pembroke at all.
But Shrek said a couple of nice things about the boys down at Pembroke as well, actually.
AG Criminal Law, get on board. Benitziotis and Webster were the goal scorers there for Pembroke. Ward, Webster, Richardson, Shibuki and Sebastian Acker were the best for Pembroke.
Well done. Old Iggy's Chingy with five, Liam with four, Jurisovic, two, Ryan, Manning, Allen, Depoy, Stevenson, Scanlon with one each. And the best players were Depoy, Scanlon, Ryan, Chinny and Stevenson.
And own HQ Park. Now the next game, Athelstan hosted Mitcham, Max Amber and Athelstan as predicted getting the job done easily. 16-8, 104 to Mitcham, 5-1-31.
Easy win, going into the finals as well, another confidence booster, but long year for Mitcham, I think, in the A's and B's. I'll be pretty glad that's over.
Are they, how bad were they going in there with the A's?
The A's are eighth, but I believe that there's only one side going down from Div 3.
Oh, that's right.
Nine, so they'll stay up on account of that.
Cool, man. Athelstan's goal scorers with McPeak with four, Langman with three, Cronshaw, Fabian, Sykes with a couple. Bates, Jonas, Cronshaw, Osborne and Tomaselli were the best players.
Mitchell's goal kickers were Trelaw with two, Hadrick, Conti, Callan with one each. Best players were Rager, Cannon, Trelaw, Hadrick and Wester Green.
So the way things finished up, Foscannon of course on the top of the ladder with 13 wins. And the two losses, so they get, because they had the draw, they get top spot over Old Ignatians by 1 point. So that's a close one.
Wow.
Iggy's and Golden Grove, Athelstan and Flinders Park, Pembroke, Plympton, Mitcham and Seton Rambler sitting on the bottom with the one win and 15 losses. So their twos have been struggling for a little while now.
They have. Even when their A's were going right, their B's were struggling. So I went to that catches up with you. Mm-hmm. When you lose a few A-grade players, you've got to rely on these blokes coming through. As you know, and it's tough to do.
And straight off the bat, leading goal scorers, big bustling Benny Dider gets a choppers there for the leading goal scorer with 58 goals from Flinders Park. Jeremy Seeney from Old Iggy's with 48, Chase McPeak with 35. Speaking of Chase, I saw an old teammate of ours.
Oh God!
At Bunnings, probably buying like spray cans. With 35, Dylan Sykes from Athelstan with 32, and Brad Morris from Golden Grove with 26.
Well done, Benjamin.
So now, first week of the finals, Old Iggy's take on Golden Grove in the same Harpers Field.
Old Iggy's for me on that one.
I think I'm agreeing with you there. I think Old Iggy's are going to just cruise through nicely. for the first week or two. Athelstan and Flinders Park at Max Amber.
Tough one.
Mm.
I don't know. What do you reckon?
I think because it is a tough one. It's a toss of a coin.
Really tight finish to the year, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's one win between, or three wins between first and fifth, really. That's a pretty even competition, isn't it?
Yeah, and especially seeing that they've got with the same thing with the buys, they get the extra rest. I think it's a very even comp. Mm. But I think only because it's out at Max Amber that Athelstan will get the job done. I was almost going to call Max my hero.
Raggies for me then as well.
Yeah, I think they'll get the job done. So that's it for this week. Make sure you subscribe to the SA Footballer magazine and we'll catch you again next week.